Hello everyone, welcome to my channel Chem Insider. In today's video, we'll be discussing about a topic called organoborines and borines. In the previous video, we learnt about the hydroboration process using borines. Now, we are completely studying and focusing our reaction process against the organoborane reagents. These organoborane reagents are also called as organoborons. This can also be written as organoborons. So it doesn't matter what you are writing, either organoboron or organoborane, both are all the same. What are organoborons? First of all, organoborines or organoborons are those species which are obtained when you are treating an alkyl or an aryl group with a borane molecule. Borines are basically either a BH3 or B2H6. When you treat these species with alkyl group or an aryl group or any something different organic compound, then they lead us to the formation of organoborines. These organoborines are also considered to be an organometallic compounds. Now, these organoborines can be used for different purposes, as they can be used for preparation of alcohol, as we observed in the hydration process in the previous video. They can also be used to prepare amine or haloalkane, an alkane group, or you can also use it for dimerization, etc. Now, let us see the different applications of organoborines. First, if you treat organoborane with an alkene species or an alkyne species, what we generally use is, we are going to treat the organoborines majorly with alkene or alkyne species only, because they are very reactive against them through an addition process of mechanism. Now, when you treat organoborines along with hydrogen peroxide under basic condition, we obtain alcohols. So this is the first application. Next, if you use the same organoborane but in the presence of acetic acid instead of H2O2, if you use acetic acid as a side reagent, we'll prepare alkane as they undergo reduction. Next, if you use a molecule of halogen in presence of basic condition, we'll prepare haloalkanes. Next, if you use AgNO3, silver nitrate, in presence of a basic condition, we'll obtain dimerization of an alkene. And the last application of organoborines is, when you treat organoborines with NH4OH in the presence of NaOCl, sodium oxychloride, will prepare amines across the double bonds. So these are the 5 different applications of organoborines when they are treated along with an alkene or an alkyne in presence of different reagents. Now, whenever you come across organoborines, there are several different types of organoborines which we commonly use for a certain types of reaction. That is because, if you consider for organoborines itself, there are two type particular classes of organoborines. One is small organoborane and the other one is bulky organoborane groups. Small organoborane groups usually give us a smaller product such as alcohol or alkane, but if you have to prepare a complicated product, then you have to use a higher classes of organoborines. So therefore, first let us discuss about different types of organoborines. Basically, we have six or seven types of organoborines which we use for several different reactions. Now, let us go through across each of them one after the other and the method of preparation of those organoborines. First is the basic one, the small or the tiny organoborane groups, which are considered as borane, that is BH3 compound, or a diborane, which is also taken as the formula B2H6. So how will we prepare this BH3 or B2H6? We can prepare BH3 or B2H6 when you treat boron trifluoride, which is in the presence of oxyethyl groups, undergoing a reduction using sodium borohydrate. That is, when you reduce boron trifluoride in an acidic condition, or if you use boron trifluoride in the presence of methylthionate, SME group, then also you can prepare boron, that is BH3 or B2H6. Okay, so this is the first type of borins. You won't be asking how are you preparing a borin, but what you have to remember is what are the reagents or the substrates required to prepare a borin. That because in some type of reactions, what they do is they won't give you the direct organoborane which you are using, but what they'll do is they give this substrates. Let us say if you consider BF3OEG twice and NaBH4, then they'll ask you need to treat the substrate with this moly reagents first in the first step, and then you are carrying out the second type of process. So then you have to understand that if you are using BF3.OEG twice along with sodium borohydrate, that means first you are preparing a borane or a diborane, and you are treating this borane or diborane with a given substrate molecule. We'll solve the examples, then you'll understand better. Next is the second one, 9-BBN. This 9-BBN is a very, very important type of borane. That is because it is quite commonly used in most of the organoborane reactions. What is this 9-borane? 9-borane is a bicyclo compound which is given by the IUPAC name 9-bora-bicyclo-331-nonane. The structure of this compound is to be written as like this. So this is the structure of the 9-BBN, which can also be written in this type of structure. The bond broken over here is indicating that that bond is present away from the observer. Okay, so here we'll be having a boron atom attached with the hydrogen. So this is the structure of 9-BBN. This 9-BBN can also be represented by a can also be denoted as 9B, a double dumbbell shape. Okay, so this is also a type of 9-BBN. So how do we obtain 9-BBN? So we obtain 9-BBN when you treat one comma five diene cyclooctane, that is so we have double bond across this octane at 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So we have double bonds at the 1 and 5th position. So this is cyclooctane, cycloocta 1,5-diene. Okay, so when you treat this 1,5 cyclooctane diene with a borane, that is BH3, you will be preparing the given species of 9-BBN. So when you are preparing this 9-BBN, you need to remember that this is a bicyclo compound. Okay, next is the third type of organoborane, which is called disamyl borane. So disamyl borane can be prepared, or the structure of the disamyl borane is given as so it is nothing but you are having a borane attached with one hydrogen, and the species is containing a branched alkane. So this branched alkane has a particular IUPAC name. So let us know, comment down below, so that you comment the name of this compound, the IUPAC name of this compound in the comment section. So let us see who all know this answer of this particular compound's name, or else I'll tell the same, I'll tell the answer in the next class. So this is disamyl borane compound. This disamyl borane compound is prepared when you are treating 2-methyl-but-2-ene with borane group. When you treat 2-methyl-2-ene borane, we obtain disamyl borane. Okay. Next is the fourth one, which is called the thexyl borane. Thexyl borane has a structure like this. You might not have observed this thexyl borane in this type of structure. That is because thexyl borane is also represented by a different structure like this. So this is the other type of structure of thexyl borane, which is a tetra substituted, which is obtained by a tetra substituted alkane when treated with borane group. When you are treating a tetra substituted alkene with borane, you will prepare thexyl borane. These are the very basic type of organoborane. Next is albine borane, which is a complicated kind of a structure, which is obtained by treating 9-BBN with alpha pinine. So first let us write down the structure of alpha pinine. Alpha pinine is almost a structure similar to camphenyl group, such as a 6-membered ring, a methyl group, and a double bond present attached to the methyl carbon group. Also, we have an additional bicyclic bondage between the carbons of the 4th and 6th carbon. Okay, so this is called the alpha pinine. This compound is called alpha pinine. And this is treated with 9-BBN. So here we have a double bond species, right? When you have a double bond species and you are treating with 9-BBN, one of the bond carbon will be carrying a BBN structure. So the compound which you are going to obtain is the methyl group present on the 6-membered ring will be in the wedge bond. And we all know that BBN usually forms a cis addition. Therefore, there will be a hydrogen present over here. And we have lost hydrogen from the BBN, so remaining will be B with one bicyclic ring and the other bicyclic ring attached to it. You can write it like this itself. There is no complication in the structure of BBN. Or if you want, you can write the exact proper structure of 3, 3, 1 cyclic structure, bicyclic structure. Okay, so this is the structure of albine borane. This is the structure of albine borane. Next is diisocamphenyl borane. This diisocamphenyl borane is also given by the name IPC twice BH. Diisocamphenyl borane is also given the name IPC twice BH. So this IPC twice BH is prepared by treating again the alpha pinine but with boron group. Okay, instead of treating them with 9-BBN, we are going to treat alpha pinine with borane compound. When you treat alpha pinine with borane compound, we'll be obtaining diisocamphenyl borane. That is, we are treating two molecules of alpha pinine to form diisocamphenyl borane group twice BH. So this is the diisocamphenyl borane. Next, if you treat only one alpha pinine with borane, we'll be obtaining monoisocamphenyl borane. So this is given by the short formula IPC BH twice or BH2. So this is the other indication of borane. So these are the 7 different types of borane. In the next video, we'll discuss about the reactivity of alkenes towards the borane. Okay, as I said earlier, alkenes or alkynes are the only compounds which are going to be treated with borane species. Therefore, in the next class, we'll be learning about the reactivity of alkenes towards the boranes and different types of boranes reacting with alkene species. And later in the other video, we'll be discussing about the reactivity of alkynes towards the borane species. I hope you understood the different types of borins and the organoborane applications. So please do subscribe to my channel and share this video among your friends.